Hey, welcome back. So today we're talking about Splenda, also known as sucralose, and the fact that it is actually a gene toxin. I know you can run into Costco, Kroger, Safeway, Walmart, pull a big old bag off the shelf in the edible food aisle. You know, not to mention you can find, you know, the local fad diet influencer who's using sucralose to decrease their sugar intake. But folks, it is a gene toxin. So if you haven't already shared this podcast, this YouTube channel with your friends, family, what are you waiting for? We need some more health accumulators showing up day in and day out. If you are a Splenda consumer, you may be saying, really? Is it really that bad? I mean, come on. The FDA approved it. Health influencers and supposed health supplement companies use it in their products all the time. What I would say is recognize that nobody else has to live in your body. So clearance by the FDA, though it may be sufficient for most companies to overlook, you know, the toxicology studies that suggest differently, you're the only one that's going to live in your body and have to care for yourself and have to experience your body's negativity or health accumulation either way. Those natural words and those colorful health images, they can go a long ways in covering up significant health shortcomings when it comes to artificial additives like sucralose. So in May 2023, this is what made me think, I got to say something about sucralose again. The Journal of Toxicology and Environmental Health published their review on the effects of sucralose and the byproduct when we consume it, sucralose 6-acetate. And what they found was sucralose 6-acetate causes DNA strand breaks. So they exposed human intestinal cells and they found that it significantly increased the expression of genes that are associated with inflammation, oxidative stress, and cancer. So think about this. Honey, maple syrup, molasses, stevia, date sugar. These are not gene toxic and they do not promote, you know, dysregulation of genes that are associated with cancer. And they have minerals, vitamins, health-promoting phytochemicals. They actually can nourish the body. This is the difference between actual sweeteners and artificial sweeteners. Nourishment versus DNA destruction and gene impairment. The researchers also noted that the amount of sucralose 6-acetate in just one sucralose-sweetened drink, like your cup of coffee or your pre-workout, could very likely far exceed the threshold for gene toxicity. So instead of, you know, potential benefits of green tea, black tea, coffee, or even your protein drink, you could be slurping down a known gene toxin in, say, sucralose, and literally stressing out the instruction manual needed to promote survival, regeneration, and reproduction. Isn't that crazy? I know these are heavy words, but I can't figure out why anyone knowing this would knowingly put sucralose into their body when there's a whole host of nutrient-dense, delicious, readily available sweeteners on the market that do not promote DNA derangement, are not gene toxic. So people talk about, you know, having leaky gut and sucralose is another artificial culprit known to devour the intestinal barrier. And recognize, the farther you get from whole foods, the closer you get to disease and dysfunction. The more challenging you make it for your body to thrive when stressors mount, when the environment around you is not, you know, optimal, it's less than optimal. So I suggest, you know, create life margin in every area of life. Where you can control things, control things. Elimination of artificial sweeteners like Splenda, aspartame, Ace-K that have no nutritional value. This seems like a natural step for anybody who wants to see their body blossom and live to their highest level. If you've not been able to get off the Splenda train yet, consider that a 2018 study showed that sucralose is a bioaccumulator in fat tissue. This was in animals. So even when you stop consuming it, there is a time frame of at least 2 weeks where it will still be present in your fat tissue. You know, and this what this has suggested, and a 2020 study showed, was that sucralose increased fat accumulation and expression of genes that cause more fat accumulation. So sucralose, I don't think it belongs in your house, just like it doesn't belong in my house, my body, probably doesn't belong in your body. It's not natural. It's not made for human consumption. Check out your honey, check out your maple syrup, check out your molasses, your date sugar, even coconut sugar. Check out your stevia, your monk fruit. Get something that came from the earth, that was not manipulated in such a way that it's, you know, hundreds and hundreds of times more intense than anything you would ever consume in nature. All right. Hope this helps. Be sure to like, subscribe, share. Dr. Matt, I'll see you guys, gals, next week.